Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, this the news beat presented to you by ladies like and just sent, you know. Follow the beat from the studio to the street. Info with the flow keeps you sharp and in the know. Sit back, relax, enjoy the news, follow. Check it out. I got some money from 1991.
That's cool, but we know the more recent one.
That was last year that they minted money. Since then, they used fakes of foreign currency.
The government fell apart in 1991. It seemed that the central bank was done, so private banks and mobile money took over.
But Somalia's currency has a chance to recover. Their banknotes can finally make a comeback, according to the governor of central bank.
Great, but they need money to make money. Where will they get funding to print their currency?
Somalia plans to raise funds with international donors. They already began reforming their financial sector, helped by World Bank, IMF and the US Treasury, and support from international community.
The next step is to write a monetary policy that works with the government's fiscal policy.
But their economy took a hit. That's the report. A drought destroyed their livestock, their largest export.
True, but their shilling rose in value after the peaceful elections in Mogadishu.
You make a good point. Things are looking up. Somalia is not about to give up. With secure currency and a strong policy, Somalia might get another shot to show the world what they've got.
Over the years, Uganda has managed to drastically reduce the HIV prevalence across the country, and its HIV prevention programs has put it in the spotlight internationally. Much of this success has been attributed to the prevention of mother-to-child HIV transmission. However, according to the global report from the World Health Organization, after every 1.5 minutes, a child is still born with this fatal disease, as many global communities have not yet been introduced to early infant HIV diagnosis. In Uganda, an early infant diagnosis program was introduced in 2007 by biometric scientists Dr. Charles Chiaga to treat HIV-exposed children. But collecting samples from the countryside proved to be a logistical burden, so the scientist decided to open a centralized lab in 2011. He then implemented a transport system for a network of hubs that directed all their samples to the central lab. Laboratory turnaround time was reduced from 30 days to 4 days only, and the cost of testing was also reduced tremendously. 350,000 babies have so far been tested at this establishment, and all the infected children have been inserted on treatment. Dr. Chiaga's groundbreaking work of testing babies with HIV/AIDS using molecular biology has earned him recognition in the science family. And in 2009, his program was voted the best HIV prevention program on the African continent. The medical pioneer has also written many research papers on managing the sickle cell disease in infants. Newsbeat salutes Dr. Charles Chiaga for his medical contributions and commitment. Anti-AIDS Gamblers and Illegal Operators Acts are to be banned in Uganda. Our reporter Keiko is here with more details.
Uganda is a young country full of hope, youthfulness, and energy. But the age of our population is also a danger. If jobs and education don't follow, problems will be major. Youth are living in the rural area, sell their land to buy border, come to the city in hope for a better life, but end up with no jobs or even money to survive. They look for easy way up and fall prey to the betting game. Betting needs no work or study. You can make money just by being lucky. But now the youth are spending their tuition, thinking they can turn it into millions. Some even consider it a profession. Dropping out of school to become a betting champion, Ugandan communities are being destroyed, leading to crime and unrest. Wherever gambling is deployed, in Impiji, the community wants to ban gambling forever, unrooting it like bad weed in a field and encourage the youth to do better. The government is aligned with the effort fighting underage gamblers and illegal operators. I'm Keiko, reporting for Newsbeat.
Thank you, Keiko, for that report. How powerful is Uganda's passport? If you could travel anywhere, where would you go? I'll probably need a visa. For you, I don't know. Over 50 nations don't ask for visas from Uganda, including Belize, Botswana, Indonesia, and Ghana. The passport index ranks the national passports according to the overall cross-borders access. Each passport is signed a visa-free score. The number of countries they are free to explore by visiting visa-free or with a visa on arrival. And guess who has the scores we can't even rival? The most powerful passport in the world is Germany, which has a visa-free score of 158 countries. In comparison, the score is 57 for Uganda, leaving us tied with Mongolia and Ghana. The lowest scores in the Middle East and North Africa were not a surprise. They are Iraq and Syria. The score is affected by the national security as well as the strength of its economy. The least powerful passport is Afghanistan, followed closely by Pakistan. For many who want to live in another country, the motivation is an opportunity to make money. Citizen by investment is now a big industry worth of $2 billion. The global cost of mobility paid by investors seeking for a second residency or citizenship to invest in foreign countries. I think it's time I took off to explore these options. I'll start with Fiji or Jamaica for my first vacation. that was the news on the beat. Next week will be another hit. Still ladies like a Jay Centino, reporting live and direct with love and respect. Follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat.
Yes, follow the beat.
Follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat, follow the beat.
Yes, follow the beat.